James, Brrraains A Head-Banging Life here, and we have another track by track for you. And this time we are going to one of the big four, Anthrax. And the seminal, famous album, We Have Come For You All. We've Come For You All. We have. It's we've with the apostrophe.
Yeah.
It's the ninth studio album of the thrash metal band, released May 6, 2003 through Nuclear Blast in Europe and Sanctuary Records in North America. It was the first Anthrax record to feature Rob Caggiano on lead guitar, who is of course now with Volbeat, and it's their final studio album with John Bush on vocal. So let's get this out of the way at the start. Favourite Anthrax vocalist?
It's difficult. I've been lucky enough to see him with both. I've seen him with John Bush
and
with why can't I think of his name? The handbag.
The handbag.
I love him. It's not disrespect.
Joey Belladonna.
Yeah, sorry.
It's really like, went out of my mind briefly there.
Yeah, I've seen him with both, and they're both different energies. Like, obviously, Joey's like the classic.
I haven't listened, right, so Anthrax, right, I'm not a band I ever cared for. I never really give them much time a day back in a thing. I heard some of their songs, never really cared for. In fact, songs I heard were the stuff that was more popular that they had kind of done crossover stuff with, and I couldn't really get why these were considered one of the big four thrash. I'm going to say something controversial. The real big four is Anthrax are not part of that. Testament are, in my opinion. Or maybe a five, but there you go. Anyway. So I never really knew the difference between vocalists and all that until I started to see Anthrax live. Now, by fucking chance, thanks to Bloodstock booking them on a reg, I've seen Anthrax more times than I can count. More times than I want to.
But you've not seen him with John Bush, have you?
No, I won't. No, and I won't. Yeah. Realistically, I won't. But that's fine by me. Yeah. Because listening to them and listening to this album all the way through, give me Belladonna every day.
Yeah.
But John Bush is a great vocalist. This album is a good album. But Belladonna, just to me, has got more range.
Yeah, there's something I love about John Bush and some of the stuff that he's done with Anthrax. Some of his songs are like my favourite Anthrax songs.
Yeah, do you know what? On this album is one of my favourite Anthrax songs.
I'll see if it's the same. That'd be quite interesting.
Yeah.
And I think with John Bush, we still get him in Armored Saint. So we're quite lucky in that respect.
Just
to hear him and his like vocal output and his band, because he's in Armored Saint and another good band.
Yeah, so there's no John Bush isn't around doing anything. We have that.
Cool. Yeah.
We have Belladonna doing his stuff in Anthrax. It's perfectly fine. But yeah, so this was the last studio album with John Bush. And I think it's a bit of a long one. It's a little bit of a long one.
Yeah.
Needs some shit cut, but there you go.
Yeah.
It opens with Contact. It's a rising intro. I like how it builds on volume.
Same here, yeah. Just an intro.
Yeah.
Gets you kind of excited for it. Yeah, obviously last album. I don't know if they didn't know back then, did
no,
they?
No, I doubt that would never have been something you'd know.
No, but... still, no, it's a good intro.
Yeah, and it kicks into What Doesn't Die. Bang and beat, a ton of spit to the vocals. Urgency in the verses are what I like, but the chorus isn't half bad either. And the tempo shift is pretty cool too.
Yeah, one of my top tracks on the album.
Yeah.
I can say it's really good. It just really kicks in that proper kind of fresh What Doesn't Die and the way the drums build. Yeah, really good track.
I mean, yeah, as a starting sort of track to an album, you want to start hot and heavy, and it delivers that. Then we get something different quite early on with Superhero, in my opinion. I think there's a grungy, psychedelic edge that works nice enough.
Yeah, I said it's a good track, but
experimental.
Nothing, yeah, good track, but nothing special on the album.
No.
Especially after What Doesn't Die, the tempo drop for me was a bit like, oh, okay.
Yeah.
So not my favourite album, but I still enjoyed it.
Refuse to be denied. For me, the huge roar at the start implies it's going to be a bit more of a heftier beast than it actually is. The tempo's a little too slow for me in the verses, but the chorus is fire.
Yeah, I thought the same. Yeah, I like the drive, but the slower parts, momentum's kind of gone a little bit there.
Oh, and it kind of sticks that way for a while, because it hits Safe Home. Now, admittedly, I do love this track. It's one of my favourite John Bush Anthrax tracks. It's catchy as hell, mellow, but it's got spirit. Mm. Yeah, I mean, Safe Home is a banger.
It's one of my favourite. And the video used to be on Kerrang and Scuzz a lot. Have you seen the video?
No.
It's like it's live video in the Spurs. There's Keanu Reeves just like jogging down the road. It's a really cool video because it shows all their fans and stuff like that. So obviously Safe Home, it's a really good video.
Okay, I'll take your word for it.
It is really good, yeah. I know what I am and I'll always be. It's better than I could dream. All my fears tumble back to life, and I stand and fight the whole world for you. And destiny, I never did believe. My only God is love.
Any Place But Here. I quite like this. The soft and strumming guitar, the pace picking up and kicking into a groovier little number.
Another favourite of mine on the album.
Okay.
Yeah. I do like to say the way it builds up gets you really excited for it. And it's like, I sing along.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I like it. Yeah, I like it too. Mm. And Nobody Knows Anything. For me, it's a welcome burst of energy at this stage. It's got punk spirit and a belly full of life. Yeah, I needed this at this point as well because I was like, holy shit, this ain't that thrashy.
No, it's not, really.
You know, it's overall as an album, I'd say it's very, you know, when you like, in the quintessential what's a thrash album, this is not it.
No, yeah, definitely not. But yeah, I put good energy. I like the way it bounces along.
Yeah. Yeah, it's simple as that. It's just a fast-paced track. Mm. Strap It On, which features Dimebag Darrell. It's got Dimebag on it, right? Mm. So you know the riffs are going to slay before you even heard it.
Yeah.
However, if I'm honest, this is lacking a lot. Boring. I got bored. I found it repetitive. And there is fuck all of a hook on it, like a killer hook.
Yeah, it didn't do much for me.
I was generally like, oh, okay. That it. Mm. You know? Yeah.
Same. And I did giggle when they said Strap It On.
Oh, okay.
Immature. I know.
Could be anything.
I know it could be, but I was being immature and childish.
Yeah. Black Dahlia, a nice slab of heavy, something that is obviously, as I've said already, surprisingly lacking in this album overall. So it's a bit of an oddity because it is so, it's probably one of the heavy, if not the heaviest track on the album. It's just kind of, oh, you're doing that now.
Yeah, it's definitely same for me, a welcome burst of just, oh, this is a lot heavier. And the fact it is just really makes it stand out as a track, which is a good thing.
I like it, but I don't get it. No, there's the problem, right? It's not like, oh, I love this track because it happens to be heavy. That's irrelevant. For me, it doesn't fit anymore.
Mm.
Because nothing else is like this, so to speak. There's faster and thrashier stuff.
Yeah.
But this is one of the heaviest tracks on it. It's like, what the fuck's this doing here then?
Mm, it is a bit of a mixed...
It's very mixed, yeah.
A mixed bag of an album. There's no kind of real one theme. Lots of few tracks that kind of really show that up. I'm like, oh, okay. Not in a bad way, but just in a... There's no real... flow to it in that sense.
No, and that's proven by the next track, Cadillac Rock Box, which also features Dimebag Darrell. I think it's an improvement over the other one, Strap It On. I like the guitar drawl and the southern whiskey soaked rhythm is what I wrote.
Yeah, it's got a sense of like enjoying it.
But how do you go from Black Dahlia to this, and then what follows afterwards as well?
Mm.
When you were saying about the lack of there's a lack of cohesion in this album. It's a bunch of songs put together, dare I say, to a degree.
Yeah, it does feel like that.
Yeah.
When you listen to it.
But I do like this track.
I liked it. It kind of, it's very Anthrax. Because Anthrax never been like a depressing band. If that makes, what's the word, dark? There's never been like loads of darkness to Anthrax in the same sense as other bands.
Okay, yeah. I think there's like a more fun factor.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you were to say to me, which of the big four looks like they're the most fun to be around, I'd be like, yeah, Anthrax.
Yeah.
You know?
See them live, they've always got that kind of more party feel.
Yeah.
So this goes well with them.
Yeah, I like it. Then we get Taking the Music Back, which features Roger Daltrey. Now, I sort of double-taked this one. I was like, Roger Daltrey?
Who?
Thank you.
Yeah.
At what point did it look like I didn't know who Roger Daltrey was? In fact, the way I'm speaking suggests I know exactly who he is, and I'm wondering how on earth this connection comes about, particularly in 2003. Mm. So it's an odd connection. And I think it's cool. And here's the thing, right? I don't really think he does anything worthwhile on this.
No.
But if you can get Roger Daltrey of The Who on your album...
then you are...
You're going to fucking take it, even if he just wants to stand there and beatbox.
Yeah.
And it doesn't fit with your, I don't know, black metal sound. You're like, it's cool, Roger, you crack on, you know? It's got a bit of groove, lacks fire, very unmemorable for me.
Yeah, I find it a bit repetitive.
If it didn't have feature Roger Daltrey in it, I probably would have just glanced over it at best.
Yeah.
You know? Because once I listened a little stronger because I was aware, I was like, okay, well, I've got to hear...
What he brings to the song. Yeah.
It kind of reminds me of another track by track that was done recently with My Chemical Romance's The Black Parade. Go check out that video with Brendan. And one of the songs, Liza Minnelli, pops in. But you have to really, really work to find where she is in that. And I didn't get it. I was like, fuck.
Yeah,
like you would again. You would never turn down Liza Minnelli, you know. But you know, front and centre, lady, yeah. You're Liza Minnelli, and likewise, you're Roger Daltrey, front and centre, please, mate. You know what I mean? Yeah. Crash. One word I wrote.
Outro.
Pointless.
Yeah.
Pointless.
Because it's not really an outro, because there's.
It's not an outro. It's just a random intermission.
Yeah, that's the word, intermission. Sorry, not outro.
I was about to say, I've got two extra tracks then.
Yeah, intermission. Yeah.
Pointless. Yeah. I don't get it at all. Yeah. Why is it there?
Yeah.
And then, because then we get Think About the End, a penultimate track. At first, I thought I was hearing something from Soundgarden.
Mm.
However, when it kicks in and they knock out that riff, it's way better. Although it's far too long, I do enjoy it because it has a kick-ass chorus.
Yeah.
No,
I thought the bits in between, the verses drag a little bit for me.
Mm-hmm.
But overall, I enjoyed it. And I think I've found a version that's got a couple of extra tracks. But we'll discuss that when we get to them. Think about it and we can live with it. Think about it and I can give you. Think about it and I'll satisfy. Think about it and we can live with it. Think about it and I can give you. Think about it.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Right, see, I purposely made sure, again, I checked to make sure this wasn't the extended or deluxe edition or something like that.
It's strange because there was two versions and I listened to one that didn't have the extra part on the title. So I just called it We've Come For You All and it still had these two tracks on it. It's just acoustic version. So one was safe.
Oh, right. Yeah. Okay. No, you are. I purposely left them off.
Oh, okay. So it was Safe Home acoustic version, which I absolutely love because I love the original version.
But we haven't got to the last track and then you can do your extra tracks. You skipped one.
Well, the song's called Think About An End. So I think I kind of automatically assumed that was the end song.
No, the last song is actually We Have Come For You All, the title track. For me, it's a bouncy finish and fitting. I found it very fitting for an album that has focused on good rhythm over thrashy heaviness overall. That was kind of my summation of the album as a whole, where it's like, you know what? You've got some good riffs, you've got some nice rhythms, there's a fair bit of rock here, some hard rock stuff, there's some metal stuff, there's a combination of everything. There's nothing wrong with that. I think it's a good album. And you focused on that over going, here's a thrash album.
Yeah. And say the track title is We've Come For You All. So it doesn't, literally, whatever you want, this is what Anthrax. Do you not think?
No, I don't get that. I don't get that. I just think it's a pithy, catchy, you know, We've Come For You All. It rolls off the tongue easily and sounds a bit like dangerous.
Yeah.
No, I don't see that at all.
Oh, okay. Another meaning of the...
But I know the two tracks you're on about, and one of them's acoustic version of Safe Home, because I started to listen to it and I turned it off. Hated it.
What?
Hated it. That needs a little bit of... That needs electric guitar.
Well, I really need to hear that.
I like the fuzz. I want to hear that little bit of, you know, not this. No, I didn't like it. It's the thing about Safe Home is it's already quite a light track, which is already to me pushing it. And it's like, that's fine, but it's because it's nice and it's a good track and I like it a lot. But you're going to make it lighter.
Yeah.
And I was like...
Oh, actually, I really love John Bush's vocals. And it was just him and the guitar. And I really loved that because the whole song
but
coming
it's
through.
Not, yeah, but that implies that the actual Safe Home track in somehow way buries or confuses vocals. They're not. They are front and center in that mix. Except what you get with... What you get with the original is that bounce, 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 bam, 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 which you lose in the acoustic side because it doesn't quite have that thump of the drums in the background are beating along to it.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm right.
I liked it.
And the other one was...
We're a Happy Family. So obviously it says that We're a Happy Family acoustic version, but it starts off with just them doing a cover of We're a Happy Family.
Uh-huh.
And then it goes into silence and then... Yeah, it's a bit of an odd thing to finish with, but again, that's why it's just been tacked on the end, so it wasn't really anything...
Pointless.
Album-wise, yeah.
Yeah, and it wasn't on the original release.
Yeah.
So that's why I didn't cover it. Yeah. Never do. Okay, top three tracks then.
Safe Home, Any Place But Here, and What Doesn't Die. So straight in.
What Doesn't Die, Safe Home, and Cadillac Rock Box. There's my three. There you go, there's Anthrax as We Have Come For You All. Let us know your thoughts in the comments. Thank you very much for watching. You can check us out on gbhbl.com as well as on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and Tumblr. Go to Patreon to help us out over there. That's patreon.com/gbhbl as well as Big Cartel where you can find some of our merchandise. We have a podcast running on SoundCloud and Apple Podcasts. And of course, if you like this video, do us a favour, hit the subscribe button and help the channel grow. Games, horror and heavy metal. What else is life for?